Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com. We're going to talk about airway face today. And sometimes when you work with me on a case, I say, whoa, that's an airway face. What is an airway face? Well, an airway face is a face that didn't grow the right way. Could be a little kid. If it's a little kid, we can still do things. If it's an adult, sorry, can't do things. I mean, we can still do things. We can work on their airway. We can work on their sleep. We can work on potential OSA. We can do ortho, which might make things better. We can do myo, which might make things better. May need myo surgery, don't know. May need jaw surgery, don't know. May need ENT surgery, don't know. May need all kinds of stuff, don't know. But certainly a lot easier to catch it in a growing kid and to fix it so that they don't have a permanent airway face. So my Napoleon Dynamite is my typical adult airway face. Usually mouth breathing, relaxed lips posture that's usually open, less nasal breathing, most likely is mouth breathing at night, just to guess. Usually makes all kind of noises when they sleep. Can even make noises. I mean, I know this one kid and the mom I don't want to deal with is not a patient, just someone I know, but I've known him since he was little and I've tried to make little hints. And I mean, he's an adult now, but I mean, the kid, when he breathes, like in your car, if he's driving in your car, you can hear him. He sounds like Darth Vader. Airway face, and his mouth is always hanging open. So sad. I mean, clearly has nasal obstruction, and I kind of talked to the mom, but the mom, nah, not going anywhere. She certainly wasn't looking for advice, so I don't like to give advice where it's not given. I've given it to some of my friends who are on Facebook before with their kids when I've never met their kids, and I see the photos, I'm like, fucking airway face. Oh, excuse me. Beep. Flipping airway face. Hey, you know, you might want to take your kid into an ortho who specializes in airway and sleep disorder breathing and just get them checked out. And I've had some friends, you know, college friends, high school friends that have been very receptive to this. I'm just telling you this because this is my specialty and this is obviously not my patient, but I see things and I'm concerned. And I just couldn't sleep with myself if I didn't tell you to go take a look. I had one person who got really mad and unfriended me. One person who was like, thank you so much. You know what? You were totally right. Totally different state. Not a kid I'd ever met. Anyways, airway face. So it basically means the face, I say face is melting. It's melting. It's melting. It's growing down and back instead of growing forward. Usually have a longer profile, very recessed chin, although maybe not class two. Could have, you know, mentalis strain here. Usually the mouth is going to hang open, often has venous pooling here. Just kind of looks tired. May or may not have behavioral issues, may or may not have issues in school, may or may not have strong physical motor skills, may or may not have learning issues, may or may not have speech issues. There's a lot of other side effects that can be tied with this. And like I said, an airway issue, and we're just calling this, or a, I mean, it can be due to so many different things. It could be due to the maxilla not growing right. It could be due to poor diet. It could be due to soft and processed foods. It could be due just to an obstructive nose. May or may not have bedwetting. I mean, there's so many things that are loosely tied to this, but at all, I mean, you just got to ask like a million questions. Obviously, if we can fix it at 2, 3, 4, 5, it's better than 5, 6, 7, 8, which is better than, you know, 9, 10, 11, 12. If this is a girl, it's more urgent than if it's a boy. We can definitely correct things if we find the source. It may or may not involve, you know, a frenum or myofunctional issues. If everything's all tethered down and the fascia's all tethered down, well, then they can't put their tongue where it's supposed to go in the parking garage. And then the maxilla is not going to develop forward, you know, and anteriorly. It's going to, you know, develop down and back, which is going to affect everything else, which is the scaffolding for the mandible, right? So everything's interconnected. So definitely, if you're a pediatric dentist or a general dentist or a parent, you should be screening for airway face. Even if you're a teacher, you should be screening for this. When you start looking into this, you start to see kids with behavioral issues, kids with ADHD, kids that are put in SPED. And then when you look at these kids, a lot of them have airway face. Which comes first, the chicken or the egg? Which one is causing this, you know? I wish that all these teachers were trained in this so that they could identify it and make sure we're fixing the problem at the root cause and not just giving our kids meds, you know, to fix it. I'm not saying it's not a part of the solution or the treatment plan, short-term, long-term, but it very well may not be needed. So, and again, I'm not saying this causes that. I'm just saying there's clearly an association. There's definitely literature supporting this. I have some of it in my channel. It's not direct, it's indirect. But these are all things, if I had a patient, or if I was a teacher or if I was a parent and I started seeing these things, I would be thinking about this. So if you are a general or pediatric dentist and you're making an orthodontic treatment plan, whether it's for a kid or an adult, and you see signs of airway face, pump the brakes on the orthodontic treatment plan. That is less important. The other stuff is more important. I know we're all in a hurry to get that start, you know, to get those funds, but that's not the right way to do things. And to be honest, your case is going to be significantly more unpredictable. It might even be impossible. It might have a terrible outcome. Weird things might happen just because the ClinCheck says it's supposed to go a certain way. If you have additional factors and variables that are forces, whether it be, you know, things not functioning together, the air not flowing right, you're not going to get what they're saying that you're going to get anyways. You could get something much worse and it could be a liability for you. So pump the brakes, do things in the right order. And sometimes parents are going to get upset. And if they are, peace out. Don't be my patient then, you know, like go to someone else who can, you know, you guys can have a bad outcome together and then you can complain together. You know, I want to be able to sleep well at night, whether it's a patient I'm treating or it's a patient I'm helping you guys with. All right. Thanks so much. And I'm telling you, really scaling and screening for airway, whether it's an adult or kids, is just a practice grower. I know you might see it as a roadblock initially. It is 100% a practice grower. Just remember, you can't say this causes that. You can say they're correlated. The research is still pending. It is something we screen for. You can always send to ENT. You can always send to Mayo and let them do a professional evaluation. And if clear, clear, right? You can always take a CBCT, have it professionally read for airway and other things. If clear, then clear. Great, you did your job. But unless you're a specialist in all this stuff, you need to phone a friend and get that information. All right, thanks.